and hope you all are doing well. Stay home, stay safe, protect yourself and your family too. And thanks for watching my videos and thanks for subscribing. If you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel and encourage me. And if you like the video, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. If you want to give any suggestions or if you need any clarification related to the topic, let me know in the comment box. I will give you a reply definitely. And don't skip the video in the middle of the session. It is an educational video. In addition, I am doing these videos by putting some effort for your benefit only. Understand that point and watch the video till the end. Definitely you will be benefited, no doubt in this. Okay, let us move into the topic of today, that is introduction to organic chemistry. And this is the most asked topic. I will see how many views will come because so many people already asked about organic chemistry. In this part of the video, I will cover only why carbon is having that property to form so many compounds and specific chemistry is there for carbon. In general, I will see, in brief, I will say, okay, whatever is required for school level. Then carbon chemistry is nothing but organic chemistry. Even though the percentage of carbon in the earth's crust is 0.02%. Earth's crust. And 0.03% present in air in the form of CO2. Even though the amount seems to be less, it is forming so many compounds. All the living organisms, most of the substances exist on the earth are made up of carbon. Because of versatility of that carbon, what is that features that favoring the formation of so many compounds of carbon, we will see. Okay, in brief I will tell. If it is lengthier video, you may not be able to pay interest to see. That's why only the most important points I am picking up and what you must remember, that I am going to say today. Carbon, so far millions of compounds known, 3 millions of compounds, and if we consider the compounds formed by the remaining all elements together, if we compare, it is far, far, far more than anything. Okay, 3 million compounds so far known, still so many are there. So what is the feature that is favoring? Means two features, catenation and tetravalency. Catenation and tetravalency. These two features are very important in consideration to carbon. Because of these two properties only, it is able to form so many compounds. And what is this catenation? Catenation is the ability of an atom to form so many bonds with the others. Okay, so many bonds. For example, carbon can form any number of carbons. It can bond with any number of carbons to form chains. Okay, they may be straight chains or they may be branched chains also, like this also. So much possibility is there in case of carbon. Okay, you know carbon is having the atomic number 6. That means what is the electronic configuration if you write 2, 4, and still how many electrons are required for the stability of this to attain the stability of this carbon? How many are required? 4 electrons are required to gain the stability. Is it convenient to accept 4 electrons? No, it is not convenient to accept all the four electrons. Because if it gone accepting the four electrons, only six protons are there, and the influence of nucleus on the electrons will reduce. It won't give stability. That is not possible. And the second choice, can it lose all these two electrons? I mean all these four electrons, so that this shell will become the outermost shell, so they will acquire, I mean carbon will acquire duplet configuration. That is also not possible. Formation of C+4 or C-4, both are not possible. It is difficult task. So what it will do? Simply it will share electrons. Okay? Simply it will share electrons, which may be between carbon-carbons or between carbon-hydrogen, carbon-oxygen with any other element, it will share the electrons. And sharing of electrons is nothing but covalent bonding. It can form covalent bond. Carbon can form covalent bond. And if you want to know about covalent bonding in detail, I will keep the link in the description box. You please go through it. So it is very easy for you to understand this. What are the conditions favoring covalent bond formation? All are given there only. You once refer it if you want to know what is covalent bond in detail. Then catenation, because it can form four bonds. Yes, it can form four bonds, and it can be with the other atoms or within the same atoms also. Carbon-carbon, it may be carbon-carbon, it may be carbon-hydrogen. Like that it can form so many chains, long chains it can form. Because of its small size, and the compounds formed are also very stable. The property is catenation. Small size is also favoring. In the same group of carbon group is there, in the same group silicon is also there. Silicon is also having the valency 4, but it cannot form this much chain. It can form up to 7 to 8 bonds with others only. 7 to 8 silicons or 7 to 8, like that it can form, but it cannot form more than that, because whatever the compounds that are formed by this are very reactive. Very reactive, they are not stable because of size, you can say. Here the size is optimum, and they can form large chains, which may be straight, which may be branched. And coming to tetravalency, we have seen four. It can form four bonds. That is one more advantage. Silicon can also form four, but the size of silicon is more. And whatever the compound that is formed, because it can react with any other atom, right? So it may react with oxygen, it may react with sulfur, it may react with hydrogen, it may react with nitrogen. Like that it can react with so many other elements. Atoms of so many other elements. So during this, whatever the compound that is formed, it will have the properties based on the type of atom which is attached to carbon. Carbon will not determine the properties of that compound. Whatever the other elements, other atoms that are combining with carbon will determine the properties of that particular compound. Okay? And in this part of the video, what you have to understand, carbon is small in size. It cannot form ionic bond. It cannot lose all the four electrons. It cannot gain all the four electrons. So simply it will share the electrons, and it will form covalent bond. That point you need to remember. And so many compounds of carbon are there because of two reasons. What are the two reasons? Catenation and tetravalency. Tetravalency in the sense valency is four. It can form four bonds with four other atoms. That is one advantage. At the same time, it can form long chains. Any number, C10, C12, C16, so many number of carbons it can form. No other element will have these properties. This much catenation capability is not there for any other element. Even though silicon exhibit to some extent, it can form chains up to 7 to 8 atoms length only. But that too, they are not so stable as that of carbon compounds. These are the two important points. Then we will have lot many things related to organic chemistry. First of all, carbon and why it is behaving like that we have seen. Hope if you understand this, we can move to the next topic and you can understand it so easily. Why particularly this is behaving like that? That you need to understand. I think you have understood only two or three important points you need to keep it in mind. If you understand that, it is easy. Okay? Hope you will like the video. And if you like the video, please like it and share it with your friends. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and encourage me. Really, if you do like that, I will get lot of encouragement and I will do lot many videos. Okay? And that's all for today. Hope you have enjoyed. Bye bye.